Said this woman's name, I got a terrific round of applause. Tonight she's going to be singing home. She is the winner of the Baby Junior Final category last year. Her name is Beyoncé Knowles.
Beyoncé's Super Bowl performance is gaining ground. Now cops all across the country are refusing to go to her show.
Let's say, because I see a part of Beyoncé that is in fact anti-feminist, that is assaulting, that is a terrorist.
He tells us, should we try and stay, or should we run away?
50 Cent is exposing Jay-Z and Beyoncé for allegedly doing ritual sacrifices.
This is to keep God first. That's the main thing, keep God first.
Kimberly Thompson, a former drummer for the singer's all-girl band, is accusing Beyoncé of, get this, extreme witchcraft and magic spells and the murder of my pet cat.
Beyoncé is blooming. This really is Destiny's Child.
When a witch has a coven, it's normally a small thing. Witches' covens are normally 3 to 7 people. When it becomes thousands, it's called a hive. Y'all are part of that lady beehive?
I will never forget listening to my first Beyoncé album. It was B-Day, and I don't know why my sister decided to play the album every day while getting ready for work, but my young mind didn't mind. I was 8 years old at the time, and the only music I really listened to was the music that my sister, parents played, or whatever played on Disney Channel and Nickelodeon. I didn't know that it was Beyoncé at the time, I just knew the voice. As an 8-year-old kid, I was quiet, introverted, and shy, so I spent most of my time playing online interactive games, and when I wasn't doing that, I was on YouTube. I didn't really have a specific method to YouTube, I just kind of went on the website, clicked on a video, and watched. One day, I was scrolling and I saw a video, a thumbnail, and it had a light-skinned black woman and a dark-skinned black man, and they were behind this huge fiery background with a triangle with an eye in the middle. And it was at that moment that I learned about the Illuminati. And I went through this video watching rabbit hole of the concept. And in every video that I watched, this light-skinned black woman was there. And I didn't really know who this woman was, for when I watched the videos, they had her voice disguised in this weird, morphed, menacing way. And the music that was supposedly her music was always played backwards. The music that this woman made was demonic and that she was a devil worshiper. One day I was driving with my parents, and of course the radio is playing and a song comes on. It sounds familiar, like super, super familiar. And I'm singing, I'm dancing, I'm trying to figure out where this song is coming, where it came from. And after the song ended, the radio host said the name Beyoncé. And that is when it clicked. Why did it take so long to click for me? I have no clue. But it clicked that this woman that my sister used to play all the time, that I felt confident that it made my shy self want to dance, that same woman, it was the woman that I was consuming that was part of this cult. It was the same woman that was demonic and was devil worshiping, and that she did so many inhumane things to get to where she is. I started off this video with my personal story because when you hear the name Beyoncé, what do you think of? When you ask someone out on the street or your family, friends, what do they think of? Do we think about Beyoncé's own mouth, her own words, or her own words and mouth of her loved ones? Or do we think about the continuous gossip narratives and stories that we hear from strangers that are talking just to talk? Throughout 26 years of her career, Beyoncé has been under the scrutiny of being dehumanized. It has gotten to the point where people have become okay of taking away someone's humanness. But why is that? Well, we have seen it throughout Beyoncé's career that she has remained a private person, especially when it comes to her personal life. And quite frankly, people do not like that, especially with the growth of social media. Due to the media's and the parasocial relationships created by them, people have become not just interested in the rise to fame, but also the fall. And because throughout her career, we have not seen a necessary slip up or fall from Beyoncé, people decided to take things into their own hands to create spurious narratives and stories. Has she had controversies? Yes. Some of them, however, were not necessarily from her. If anything, it comes from these interesting narratives and stories, assumptions, crazed ideas about her and her family, along with interesting expectations for her as a human being. Even if controversies did involve her, truthfully, you will have to watch and listen to her work to get the little scoop that she would entail. And believe it or not, people don't like that, especially with folks that have any form of status. They don't want to see these people have their own narrative in their own hands. Because as consumers, we have become entitled to want more and more from the people that we are consuming from. And if we don't get it, we create narratives. Without even knowing it, it shifts into dehumanization, where we do not see these people that we used to listen to or watch anymore as human. Instead, they're just characters and story books that we create. Speaking of, let's talk about the concept of relatability. People want to relate to people that they are watching, that they are consuming. There's nothing wrong with that. However, it does become wrong when we are forcing people to become relatable to them. Because if they aren't relatable, then they think that they are better than us. And if they do, it is a performance and fake intimacy. But let's go back to the rise to fall pipeline. I'm going to explain each step of this pipeline to you, and let me know if it sounds familiar, okay? Step one is the rise. People will say, this has been long overdue for this person, whoever it may be. They say that they knew this person was going to make it, and they were going to give that person their props, at least for the time being, until we get to step two, which is them being tired of this person, and then tiredness, it will create envy and jealousy. They start to question the relatability of this person, self and them anymore, and more specifically, why aren't they making themselves relatable to me anymore? Folks start wondering why they are losing access to a person that they thought was accessible. This will create personal vendettas. This will cause people to go through great lengths to find any story, any narrative to put this person down, to put them back on the level that they want them to be in. Either through spooled narratives, ideas, assumptions, expectations, you name it. That then goes into step three, which is the fall. In the fall, this is when we start hearing people say, see, I knew that person wasn't. No, I knew this person was off when people laugh, joke, cut this person down till their last literal breath. And then it goes into step four, when this said person gets their flowers, when they're not here to receive them. Sounds familiar? You see, this often happens, especially to Black folks that are in the entertainment industry and involved in pop culture. And that leads to my next point. You see, Beyoncé is a student of her craft. Beyoncé was able to watch and see the legends Michael, Whitney, Prince, Diana, Tina, grow through the scrutiny under the media and general public alike, is ultimately the product of their unknowing teaching. I want to read a quote from her Harper's Bazaar interview, and this is what it says. We live in a world with few boundaries and a lot of access. There are so many internet therapists, comment critics, and experts with no expertise. Our realities can be warped because it is based on personalized algorithm. It shows us whatever truths we are searching for, and that's dangerous. We can create our own false reality when we're not fed a balance of what's truly going on in the world. It's easy to forget that there's still so much to discover outside of our phones. I'm grateful I have the ability to choose what I want to share. One day, I decided I wanted to be like Sade and Prince. I wanted the focus to be on my music because if my art isn't strong enough or meaningful enough to keep people interested and inspired, then I'm in the wrong business. My music, films, art, message should be enough. Throughout my career, I've been intentional about setting boundaries between my stage persona and my personal life. My family and friends often forget the side of me that is the beast in stilettos until they are watching me perform. It can be easy to lose yourself very quickly in this industry. It takes up your spirit and light, then spits you out. I've seen it countless of times, not only with celebrities, but producers, directors, executives, etc. It's not for everyone. Before I started, I decided that I'll only pursue this career if my self-worth was dependent on more than celebrity status. I surrounded myself with honest people who I admire and who have their own lives and dreams are not dependent on me. People I can grow and learn from and vice versa. In this business, so much of your life does not belong to you unless you fight for it. I fought to protect my sanity and my privacy because the quality of my life depended on it. A lot of who I am is reserved for the people I love and trust. Those who don't know me and have never met me might interpret that as being closed off. Trust. The reason those folks do not see certain things about me is because my real ass does not want them to see. And so I ask again, why as a society have we normalized the concept of dehumanization? The answer that I would want, but I don't think I would ever hear a justifiable answer. Regardless of the amount of fame, status, or success achieved, that does not take away from somebody's humanness and human experiences. As I watched a Renaissance film this past week, it felt so good being able to hear the stories and narratives from the woman herself, other than the narratives and stories that were put upon her. And the thing about it is, Beyoncé is not explaining her humanness here. She is rather making it known that her experiences are just as valid. Whoever chooses to believe it or not, whoever wants to understand it or not, and whoever likes it or not. You'd be wondering, where do I stand now? Well, I guess you can say that I am part of the hive. Younger Swanda would be in absolute disbelief. I am now finally going to her tours, shows. I am finally being unapologetically a fan of someone that I absolutely admire and is inspired by in my own creative endeavors. The thing is that I am not making this video as a fan. Instead, I'm making this video as a human being. Making this as a human being that sees another human being despite of the labels, despite of the stories that were put upon her. I'm writing this as an apology to my younger self that I didn't get to bask in the representation that was right in front of me. Even knowing it, I was being valued and seen by Beyoncé. Without even knowing it, she was representation of a storyteller, visionary, and businesswoman that I aimed to be as I got older. And instead of being able to receive that, being able to be able to revel in that, bask in that, I was told that this woman was demonic, was evil, was inhumane, and this was words that was coming often from my own community, that she was a monster disguised as a Black woman. About time that when we say the name Beyoncé, that we do not hear the labels and the stories and the narratives being brought upon her. Instead, we should hear human. And hearing that word human, that should be enough.